Hi, I'm Susan Schaefer, and I'm the publisher of Island Arts Magazine. I'd like to welcome you to Artist Talk.
Well, good morning. I'm here with my featured artist, Jodie Blaney, and I was really attracted by her use of bright, colorful, and bold images. So we are featuring her in our November 2022 edition, and it's issue number 62. Good morning, Jodie. How are you?
Yeah, good morning. Great to be with you today.
Good, thanks. Where are you located?
So I live in a small town called Ladner, which is in South Delta, about 10 minutes from the Tawasin Ferry Terminal.
Okay. And that's where you are today in your studio?
Yeah, I'm here in my studio. So I have actually a backyard studio gallery where my work is always set up. So I spend my days here. And when I'm not out delivering work or meeting with my customers, I tend to be here in my backyard studio.
Nice. So you're very close to the ferry if you need to get across.
Yeah, I go over quite often. I've spent the last 2 weekends over on the island, Salt Spring Island, and then over in Souk.
Oh,
I like to go
nice.
over there and visit family and do lots of sketching. That's mainly what I'm doing over there, sketching and hiking and finding inspiration on the island. So.
Oh, there's lots of inspiration over here, that's for sure. So
yes.
You told me that since 2018, you've been working as a full-time artist. So I wonder, what did you do before that?
I did a lot of different types of work. I've been mainly freelancing for about 10 years. So copywriting and editing. So doing a lot of kind of corporate copywriting, that kind of thing. So websites, helping with web design. So, and then prior to that, I worked in the field of educational publishing, where I spent about 12 years. So I've been in different types of industries, mostly publishing and now the art field, but I've been working across Canada doing different types of jobs in sales and marketing management. So I had quite a corporate sort of business existence before finding my way into the art world full time in 2018.
Well, that would, you appear to be really, you know, good at the marketing aspect of the business.
Yeah, you know, I think about it now that I think there were a lot of benefits to having that many years in kind of a more formal sort of corporate setting, because I was able to acquire a lot of skills that could help me as I was moving forward into my art business. And I think about that a lot, actually. It's one of the reasons I wanted to be self-representing as an artist, because I really felt that I could bring a lot of my background into my position that I have now. So.
So what are you working on now? Can you show us something?
I'm working on a commission, which is quite a large one, 46 by 46 inches. And I'm working on some new autumn inspired paintings based on sketches and ideas from my recent hikes. So.
Good. In your interview in the magazine, you said that you took a drawing course with Emily Carr at the Emily Carr College, right, in Granville Island. And at first it was drawing and you weren't really into it. And you thought, oh, you know, and then once you got into the flow of it, it became part of your daily practice now. So I think, can you comment on that, how that has really, your head sort of turned around and like a lot of people, they just sort of think, oh, I don't need to do the drawing. I'll just jump right into the painting aspect, right?
Yeah, and I used to do that quite a bit. I would just jump right in and start, in a sense, kind of drawing and painting almost simultaneously on the canvas. But what I started to realize, it really all the freedom and all the expression, all of the ideas are worked out in the sketchbook. It took me a long time, many years to realize that. But anyways, Going back to my reluctance with drawing, I think I always had this idea that I had to draw very realistically, that there was kind of an association in my mind between math, which I'm really not good at, math and drawing. I needed to be realistic and precise, render things realistically, and I kind of really avoided drawing for those reasons, because I kind of had that in my head that I would have to have those kind of skills. But then when I actually started to sketch, I realized there was so much freedom in the sketching, and that I could really take my, I could just take my pencil, my charcoal, I could take it in any different direction. And it became more about exploring balance and composition, light and dark and tonal value. I didn't draw realistically from the beginning. I think it was just a decision I made. And as soon as I gave myself permission to actually just draw that way, the way I felt, the way I really wanted to, it just opened up everything for me. And I think my stylized sketches that are really the beginning of my stylized paintings are just worked out very carefully in my sketchbook beforehand. That's where all the fun is for me. That's where the excitement is in discovering a drawing that feels balanced and feels right. And then I move confidently to the canvas once I got the drawing down.
I think what you did was you gave yourself permission to have fun.
And yes, exactly. I'm still giving myself permission to have fun. That's an ongoing thing.
Instead of, being a strict sort of thing. And the drawing aspect, I took a class with Mike Swab. Do you know him?
Yes, I took a class with him as well.
Well, and one of the things that stuck in my head was and I quote this to my students, is that if you can't make it work on paper, you're not going to make it work on canvas. So work Absolutely. Out all your glitches on the paper first, and then you go to
yes.
canvas. So, and I interviewed him in my summer issue, and he still does that. He says he does at least 20 drawings before every painting.
Yeah, it's funny because Mike, I took a weekend class, with just learning acrylics with Mike Swab, and so many little nuggets of wisdom. I bought his book as well. Excellent.
Yeah.
But there were a few things that really stuck with me, and maybe with you as well. The idea, if you can't work out your idea in that thumbnail sketch, the really small one, don't even move forward. Work it out small. Something small, make sure it's got high impact. If it doesn't have impact on a paper, it's not going to transform itself on the canvas. It either works there, and if it doesn't work there, you don't move forward. But just funny with his, I do recall him saying, this one was stuck with me too, is that he says, you always want to be looking for the design, the graphic design aspect of your subject. Asking yourself constantly, why am I painting this subject? What is it about the shapes and the line and the movement that is attracting? What is the purpose of painting this scene? And he always said, you can't paint pretty. I mean, you can photograph, you have to paint something that draws the eye in, a design. It's all about the design. And that always stuck with me with his.
Okay. So because you start every painting with designs, you must have quite a collection of them. So have you given any thought to maybe having a show of
these? I do. I've got several. Yeah, it's funny. It's funny you should ask that, because I just recently at a couple of my last art shows, I've had some visitors come up to me and say, would you consider selling the sketches? Is it something you've thought about? I didn't think about it until about 3 months ago when there was quite an interest in them. I always kind of considered my sketches more for personal use, just personal mm-hmm. reference. But as I'm looking back on them, it's kind of the evolution of my body of work as well. So I might consider if there's interest, I'll consider showing them.
Maybe down the line you can do a retrospect.
Yeah, I mean, I'm definitely hanging on to all the sketches. I have a really good collection going back years now. So,
well, I bet you do. Yeah,
very good. Yeah.
As an artpreneur, which means that you're managing all aspects of your business, from the painting, the marketing, the shipping, all that kind of stuff. Is there some aspect of that you find harder than others?
There are a couple things. I think the I wasn't expecting that I would be doing so much shipping.
And that's a good thing.
I think probably about half my I think I probably ship about half of all my artwork that I sell some shipments to the US, but mostly across Canada into Ontario, Quebec, and East Coast. So I wasn't expecting to do so much shipping. So that has brought some logistical challenges of just packaging and shipping and getting things out the door. It takes up a fair amount of time. I'm getting a little more streamlined with that. But the second part that is a bit challenging is I launched an online print shop on my website, Canada Day. So just recently, a few months ago. And that has kind of moved my business a little bit more into a retail setting in a sense, because it's a drop shipment. So the orders, print orders are placed directly through my website. And so I'm now dealing with a printing partner out in Toronto who is manufacturing and shipping the work for me. So it's kind of brought in a new business relationship and a new aspect of my business where I really have to kind of keep an eye on the orders as they're coming in and going out. So that's kind of new, just having a little bit more of a retail presence to my business, not just simply working my studio and selling an original work, but selling the reproductions on canvas, paper, metal as well. So
have you worked out a schedule to where you maybe paint in the morning and do your marketing in the afternoon, or how does your day go?
Yeah, I follow actually a pretty good schedule. Social media has become a really important part of what I do every day. I used to think of it as something kind of on the side of my business, but it's really core now. It's about a third of my it's up to a third of my time, mm-hmm. because I'm constantly talking to my followers online, and I'm kind of always posting like in the flow of my day, posting what I'm working on, what I'm doing. So I allow probably 2 to 3 hours a day for social media, up to an hour a day for packaging, several hours a day for emails, communication. The actual art production is starting to shrink, which is a concern. I need time to paint, but there are a lot of parts to the business that I have to manage. And so I start quite early in the morning. I've been getting up like quite early to get going. And I usually work most evenings too, because I love it. So it's a full day. It's more than an 8-hour day.
And I've been following you on Facebook. What other social media platforms are you using?
Yeah. So Facebook, I spend a lot of time on Instagram, and I've kind of more recently been involved with Pinterest, because I find that there's a lot of good opportunities there to connect with people that are looking for West Coast inspired artwork. So I'm on Pinterest quite a bit now as well. But Instagram and Facebook are still my main social media where I tend to interact and post my work.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's working. So do you have any shows coming up this winter that you'd like to tell us about?
Well, I have a show that's my next show is called the For the Love of Art in South Delta show. That is November 5th and 6th, so that's just around the corner. I don't really have any shows coming up until the spring at this point. After that, I have my studio here in Ladner that is set up all the time with my artwork, so I tend to this is kind of my show and sale behind me year round, I guess you can say. But I don't really have any shows now till next spring and summer. And yeah, spring, summer tend to be the busy times for me.
And so your summer was pretty busy this year?
Yes. Yeah. I was involved I was involved in several shows in the Vancouver area. And I participate as a volunteer for a number of events too. So that keeps me busy. The West of Maine Art Walk, Mid-Maine Art Show, the West Fine Art Show, mm-hmm. out in a winery out in Langley. So yeah, it was actually a very, very busy summer. And then I usually end up with a number of commissions that I have to kind of work on now. So following those art shows.
Oh, very good. Mm-hmm. Well, is there anything else you want to talk about? That's all my questions I have.